Hello, welcome to a new video. It's been a while since my last video. I finally got my new caravan in August, and I spent most of my time doing some camping and photography since then. But now it's time for another video. I actually forgot how intimidating it is to be all alone in the woods and talking to a camera, but I hope I'll get used to it again. Today I'm going for some mushroom hunting. I would like to make some macro photos of mushrooms. I really like macro photos of mushrooms because I think they're quite cute and fairy tale like. So that's what I'm going to do today, and let's see if we can find some. I think we can. There used to be a lot of mushrooms in this forest, so let's go and look for it. So, I found a cute little mushroom here on the ground, and I'm going to take some macro photos of it. And I would like to do some focus stacking, and that would be a lot easier if the light wasn't changing so much today. It would be a lot easier if it was overcast, as they said it should be today. So I'm blocking the sun with my bag, so I get a constant shadow around the mushroom, and then I'm adding some light with a speed light. It would be quite boring to look at if it was all in shadow. So I'm using the light to add some contrast to the image. When you're using a macro lens, you can get really close to the subject and make them fill the entire frame. The downside, or actually it's also the upside, is that the field of depth is very, very shallow. You can only have a few millimeters in focus at a time. So that's why you use focus stacking. And you do that by taking a lot of photos with different parts of the subject in focus. So I know now roughly where the front and the back of the mushroom is in focus, and then I'm taking a lot of photos with each part in focus, and then I will combine them in Photoshop afterwards in another video. So let's adjust the focus a bit. Yeah, and one more. It takes some time, and it's important to be really, really cautious, not move your camera in between each shot. I could place it on a tripod, but it's difficult to get so close to the ground when you're using a tripod. So, small steps. Yeah, that's it, I guess. So, always take a photo of your hand to mark the end of a sequence. it makes it a lot easier in Lightroom afterwards. So that's one mushroom. I'll probably grab another sequence just to be sure that I have what I need to make a good photo. But afterwards, let's go find some more mushrooms. So I found a small group of mushrooms here, and I'm not interested in the large ones here. I'm interested in the little one here, the tall one. I think that's going to be a great subject for this kind of photograph. I'm going to do roughly the same as in the previous image. I'm blocking the sun with my back and adding some light for contrast with my speed light, and then it's all about taking some photos. So surely not the most comfortable way to take photos, but what don't you do for a good shot? So nice and easy. One small step at a time. So, I think that's about it. Yeah. The background light is changing a bit. I can't block the sun from the entire forest, but I hope it's going to work. Yeah. Well, there's no more mushroom hunting today. It's time to go home now. The sun is setting in 10 minutes, so it's getting dark soon. In my next video, I'll show how I process the photos in Lightroom and in Photoshop. So, I'll see you then. Bye bye. Thank you.